Hello students, welcome to our class. We are going to study science, keeping safe. How you should be careful in home and school. See the children, what are they doing? They are playing with electrical wire. Is it correct? No, you should not do like that. How you should safe at home? Don't use any sharp object, knife, scissors, like the things you should not use. Okay, you should not play with fire, your hand will get injured. So if you get burned, you should apply cold water to burn area. Never run on the wet floor. You should clean and dry the floor and put the mat, and you should wet the foot in the mat, then you walk. Never touch the hot things like iron and oven. And don't jump on the bed. You may fall down. Don't read on the dim light. You should switch on the light. You should not throw the toys, shoes, books here and there. Someone may trip and fall. And you also fell down. So you should keep your things in the shelf. After playing, after studying, you should keep your room clean all the time. Then only you can safe. And don't climb on furniture because they can fall and you can get hurt. So draw a support for that. And crackers are not for burning your hand or your home. Burn crackers outside the home with the help of your parents, because it may lead to fire accidents, big accidents. So you should be careful. How we should save in school? We should follow the rules. You should not stand on the desk. We may fall down or we may fall with any others. And do not jump on the desk and the chairs. If we fell down, you get injured. And you should not run around in the classroom. If the teacher is not present, you should keep quiet and sit. You should not run around in the classroom. Do not run and push each other in the corridor. While walking, you should keep line. You should not jump on the desk. Do not run in the stairs also. And never throw any things at each other in the classroom and also playground. Like pencil, eraser, should not throw. Understand? And don't touch any things in the laboratory or mix any things in the laboratory without the knowledge of the teacher. Okay, then how we should be safe while playing? While playing, we should follow the rules. Understand? And you should not play kites on the open terrace because we may get fall down. And you should not play near thorny bushes or barbed wire because it may get hurt to you. Avoid getting into fight while playing. So not fight with your friends while playing. And never go alone for swimming. While go for swimming, get your parents' guide. And while you play, you should follow the rules of the games. And while you play football like the games, you should wear shoes to prevent foot injuries. And do not fight with each other. Follow the rules of the game. And play safe games. First of all, you should play safe games. And how you should be safe on the road? In the road, while walk on the road, you should be careful. First thing, you should not run or play. Never run or play on the road. because vehicles will come. And always walk on the footpath. In the road, on the two sides, there will be footpath. Always walk on the footpath. Always cross the road at the zebra crossing. In the middle of the road, you can have the zebra crossing. You should cross the road in the zebra crossing. Cross the road only if you are accompanied by an elder. The elder only you should cross the road. Then, first look to the right, then to the left, and then to the right again. Then, you can cross the road. When you cross, you should see whether any vehicle is coming or not. If there is no vehicle, then only you have to cross the road. While waiting for bus, you should wait in a queue in the bus stop as well as inside the school also. For school vehicle also, you should wait in a queue. And never put your hand or head out of the window of the moving bus. And never disturb the drivers also. Never play inside the vehicle. Okay, these are the rules. Then, you should not play on the road. Because vehicles will come, you know. You should not play on the road. We should follow the traffic signals. Here it is, no parking, no entry, no horn. They are meant for our safety only. And you can see that traffic signal will be there in the road. Did you see that? Red color, yellow color and green color will be there. What the red color says? The red color says stop. Yellow color says wait. Green color says go. So when there is red color, we have to stop the vehicle. When there is yellow color, we have to start. And green color, we have to move. If anybody get hurt in the school and in home, what we should do? We should give first aid. So what is first aid? It is the immediate care given to a person at the time of injury or emergency before taking her or him to the doctor. So before taking him to the doctor, we should give some immediate help. That is called as first aid. So for that, we should need some things. That things should kept in a box. That is called as first aid kit. In the first aid kit, we will have some basic medicines. Understand? So what are the things we should have in the first aid kit? First thing, we should have first aid manual, okay, and gloves, and injection, and band-aid, scissors, tweezers, okay, antibiotic cream. These are the things we should have in the first aid kit. So you can see here, we are having for the burns and for the fractures, what are the things needed we should have in the first aid kit. So, be safe at home. Thank you.